Form it up, we gon' burn it down.
Since I've recorded, hear my voice, isn't it ridiculous? We're about to get a storm. They say it's going to be an insane storm, and they say that we could get tons and tons of snow. The truth of the matter is, I believe from all the other plow companies I've talked to, I got the snippies. I turned on this. They say that like Buffalo and South's gonna get like up to 4 feet of snow. Where we're at, we're supposed to get, I think, hold that up. You're perfectly fine, love. Anyway, small distraction. So we're supposed to, I think like 4 to 6 right in my immediate area, like right here around my house, and then I think like 8 to 12 in the next city over where I only have a few. But the bulk of everything we're gonna get, I think we're not gonna see over 8 inches. So I have to go and I went and detailed my truck yesterday in my shop. I have to, not detail, I cleaned it all, it was a friggin' mess. I have to go fill my truck up because it's about empty, decide which plow I wanna run in this storm, mount that, come back here, and just park it, and that's it. Because I'm not supposed to go anywhere. We'll get to that in a minute. Billy is out, I don't know where Billy is. Billy's out Christmas shopping, I think. But then he's gonna go fuel up his truck, put his plow on, come back here, park it as well. Today is Thursday, the storm's supposed to start tomorrow. I'll get into more details about the storm and why I'm not supposed to leave my house. I don't know, let's do this. The truck is dirty. Gas card.
Oh yeah.
Billy's got it. So, this storm, I don't think we're gonna get the worst of it. I think we're gonna have the least amount, maybe 8 inches total. And today's Thursday, it's supposed to kick in tomorrow sometime. And by like 1 in the morning, Friday going into Saturday, it's supposed to be gone. It's supposed to push back down to Buffalo and stay there. Hopefully it does. We'll see what happens. But they're calling for winds up to 55, 60 miles an hour. And it's supposed to be like 19 degrees. It's like 42 right now. It's supposed to be 19 degrees. And then with the wind chill, it's supposed to feel upwards of negative 45 to negative 60 degrees.
No.
I don't know if you guys can see that, but look right over there. See all those bags of cans? That's a bottle return place. That's insane. Stop me at 89. Huh, I had a quarter of a tank. That's not bad. Under 100 bucks, I'll take it. Oh yeah. Receipt for the accountant. Well, there's Billy's plow. He'll have to come and get that later and put it on the truck. But we gotta decide which plow we wanna use. Let's go open up the shop. Oh, this is the last one in here. Take this one. So, it's either take the wide out, which it's not a Western, I know somebody's gonna say that, but it's the same thing. So it's an 810. So when the wings are in, it's 8 foot. When they're out, it's 10 foot. And they scoop, to put it full scoop mode. This is a huge plow. And then the V-blades over there, which that's 8.5 feet. I like the V-blade. Definitely like this one better. You get so much more ground clearance with this one. I can move so much snow, so much further with this. So I'm gonna throw this one on this truck. Yeah. Let's throw this one on this truck and then I'll be back with you guys in a minute. I gotta put some dielectric grease in these plugs. Now you wanna hear something really stupid? There's a trick to snow dog plows. Your plugs, they always come apart on all snow dog plows. So what they do, they put holes in the corners so you can do this. Run zip ties through them to help hold them together so they don't come apart. Now you would think, oh, that's a great idea. But tell me this, if it's such a great idea and they knew this was happening, instead of putting holes in their plugs, why not just fix the problem? Because I've owned everything from Boss to Western to Myers plows, and I've never had an issue with any of my plows coming apart, any of my plugs coming apart. So instead of putting these in here like this and then designing their plugs this way, why not just fix the plug so you don't have this problem? But no, they don't do that. Doesn't make no sense to me. Apparently people smarter than me are figuring this stuff out. I would have just fixed the problem the first time. So, and because I'm anal and I don't want these hanging here, not that anybody would ever see them anyway, cut them all off. Now they're not going to come apart when I'm in the middle of plowing a storm. It works. That looks tiny like that, but that's 8 foot. I don't like the sound that shaft is making. Let's lube the shaft. I use this stuff for everything. 2+2 red grease, red and tacky. You spray it on like the rails of your garage door. I've sprayed it on rails before, and 3 years later, it's still there. Good luck getting it off your hands, but it works awesome.
All right, so that's the plow I'm going to take. Like I said, there's Billy's. That's his 7.5 foot Ultramount 2 Western. That plow is 2 years old, I think. And if you guys remember, I bought the aftermarket wings for it. I cut them, brought it in, I rewelded it down, and then welded braces and put rubber pads on the bottom. So that plow's now like a scoop. That is an awesome blade. Love that thing. This one's very similar. It just does a lot more things, but essentially it's the same thing as that. But if I end up having a problem with that plow during the storm, then I'll just come back and get my V-blade, which is only a year old. I just like that style better. But I was thinking, since it's like 40 degrees, 42, it's a mess in here. And I have an idea. Oh, why can't I leave my house? I went to bed Sunday, woke up in the middle of the night, freezing, shaking so bad I could not stop shaking, could not get warm, which is really weird because I'm a human heater. Like, I emit heat all the time. I'm always hot. It's one of the reasons I hate wearing clothes. Went back to sleep, woke up in the morning, soaked in sweat, stomach hurt, throat hurt, headache. I'm like, great. I haven't been sick in like 7 years or something. It's been forever long. Like, I work out all the time. My immune system is insane because I'm out in the elements all the time, year round, and all the vitamins I take every day. So I literally never get sick. I'm around sick people all the time, never get sick. Well, so all day Tuesday I was fine. Wednesday I was fine. I had enough headaches, but take a couple of leave, gone. No big deal. And I woke up this morning with this like scratchy throat, but that's it. Other than that, I feel fine. I feel like I can go to the gym, do a full workout, tons of energy. But for the hell of it, yesterday, I'm like, I'm going to take a COVID test. I've never taken one before. And so I had one done. And yeah, it was a 15-minute rapid test. And within 3 minutes, both lines are solid black. I got the vid. Son of a... I got the vid. But I don't know. So I'm not going anywhere besides here because nobody's here. It's my shop. No one's here. I'm not going to stores. My daughter did my grocery shopping. My mom went and got me medicine this morning, dropped it off to Billy. I've been quarantined in my bedroom. I'm not coming out of it really. Other than to go to the bathroom or get food, which I've been eating like a horse because I'm so freaking bored. I've probably gained 10 pounds the last 2 days. And then like I'm following behind me with a can of Lysol spraying everything. So if Billy does come out of his room, which he rarely does, but if he does, he usually just leaves the house and goes somewhere anyway, like he did today. But I'm spraying everything anyway because I don't want him to catch anything. But he's got a great immune system just like me. So I don't know. So the doctor says, listen, it's probably not going to affect you. The way your lifestyle is and what you do, you're probably not really going to get the side effects from it or the symptoms. Maybe something minor like the sore throat I have. He said, but what you got to worry about is carrying it to somebody. I said, no, I get that. And I definitely don't want to do that. So let me set you guys down. I'm holding you guys up for some reason. I said, yeah, I definitely don't want to do that. So he said, yeah. He goes, just take it easy. Keep yourself away from everybody. Friday night, take another one. If it's negative, take another one Saturday morning. If you get 2 negative in a row, you're fine. He says, if you leave the house over like the next 3 days after that, probably throw a mask on if you're around people. It's a good idea. I said, yeah, I get it. So that'll probably cancel me out for Christmas. We always do Christmas dinner at my mom's on Christmas Eve, and then the kids go off and do their thing on Christmas Day. So I don't have any plans for Christmas Day. I'll be by myself, which is no big deal. I don't care. I'd rather work anyway. I just want to see my kids, which I would be with them on Christmas Eve, which apparently I'm not going to be able to do now. My mom's going to have my brother drop off food to my house. But if Billy is not sick and he doesn't have it Saturday morning when I test him, then I'm going to let him go do his thing, go to his mom's and go to my mom's, stuff like that. No big deal. It's what it is. What are you going to do? I've been sick in 1,000 freaking years, and now I get the bid just before Christmas. And we get a storm. Billy and I will probably be plowing anyway. I don't know. They say the storm's going to be gone 1 in the morning going into Saturday, Christmas Eve. So we probably won't be plowing during the holiday anyway. We'll see what happens. But, you know, I don't know. But I have an idea.
Thank you.
sometimes you just gotta get out of your system. Oh.
I just changed some things up in this. So I put new Metal Militia bars on there. I got my Bark Busters that came in that go around. I haven't put them on. I've had them in for a little while. I put a new throttle on there. I got rid of the plastic one that comes stock on the bars, and I went all aluminum. I got a few other things I got to do with this. This is the 140. That's a stock exhaust, actually. It sounds pretty freaking good for a stock exhaust. But so I took the stock handlebars that come on this, and I put them on my XR100 right here. I like them on here much better, but I wanted my Metal Militia bars on here. So they're on there. Billy's buddy rode this the other day, my 110, and snapped off my clutch handle. That needs fixed. That needs a bath. They all need a bath really bad. So that needs a bath. And I'm ordering the big wheel kit for that. So that will have the same setup as this bike. And my chopper. I got a weld part of the frame back there. I rode it the other day up and down the road. And it hops like crazy when you shift gears because there's a crack in the frame in the back. Well, one of the mounts in the back. So that needs fixed. And then the 100 or the 70 needs a new bearing for the back wheel. That one will be fixed. These things got ridden hard this year. And the other 70, this is the one that Connor rode a couple weekends ago. Oh, not on that side. Over on this side. He had a rock that was in the ground. Blew a hole right inside the casing. All the oil leaked out. Did not pop this motor. So I ordered a new casing. That should be here soon. Billy's 85R big wheel kit. That's a two-stroke. That thing's disgustingly fast. That thing smokes every other bike in here. And Noah's little 70. And then Billy's 200R. For a 200, this thing, that thing's absolutely ridiculous. You would never expect that machine for a 200 to do what it does. That's crazy. I put that in some videos. And my jet ski. I absolutely hate this time of year. Oh yeah, there's one of our shitter pitters right there. That's what we call that. A little doodle bug, they call them, the Bajas. We have another one too. It's back there somewhere. Yeah, anyway. That's why I have alarms. That's why I have cameras. Because people in this town are freaking thieves. Thieves. I really don't want to have to shoot somebody just before Christmas. But I will. Yeah. So that's what we're looking at for this plowing. A storm coming up. I don't know if I will. Well, I'm sure I won't post anything between now and Christmas other than this video. So, I hope everybody has an awesome Christmas. If any of y'all are getting a storm, getting this storm or any effects from, I think a lot of people, a lot of states are going to be getting this storm. Leave it down in the comments. Tell me where you're at and tell me how much you guys are projected to get, because the worst part for us is going to be we're expecting rain. Like I said, it's like 42 right now. We're expecting rain later tonight and tomorrow. During the day, and then that Arctic blast is coming through, and they said it's going to happen within minutes and up to an hour, and it's going to go from like 42 to 19, and then with the wind chill up to negative 60. So we're going to have a flash frost. So that means any of the snow that we plow away is all going to be ice underneath it, which makes plowing snow insanely dangerous. I freaking hate when it's like that, but nothing we can do about it. Gotta do it. So, let me know. Alright. I gotta call Billy. Find out what the heck he's doing. So I can find out where he's at. Who said you got a dog? Find out where he's at, what he's doing. So I know he's gonna come over here and get this plow put on his truck. A million messages. Well, hey there, Lex. Keep on with the message. Your head keeps popping up like she's a mess. Oh, you're on lunch. Okay, give me 1 minute. Yeah, I gotta find out what he's doing. So I know he's gonna come over here. He's gonna fuel up that truck and come over here and get this plow put on so he's ready to go as well. But, oh, you know what? I probably will upload because I'll film snow plowing. That's what I'll do. I'll film snow plowing. So I don't know how soon that'll be up, but as soon as I can get it edited, publish all that fancy stuff, and then I will put it up. And you guys will get a video from me plowing snow. Maybe I'll send a camera to Billy too, and he can film what he's doing, since this will be his first time actually out plowing. I mean, he's plowed for me a little bit here and there with me with him, but he's never gone out and plowed his own route. This will be his first time, which kind of makes me nervous because the ice underneath it, and he's not used to all that. But I don't like the way this plow creaks. But this plow, I bought it used off my buddy. And I used it once last year. If you guys remember, I did the review video on it. And I used it for one storm. It was like 2.5 inches. It wasn't much at all. So I'm super excited to use it. That's why I'm taking it. But I think it's just been sitting. Hasn't been used. It seems to function great. So that's why I said if things don't work out with it, I'll just come back here, dump it, grab my V-blade, and go do what I gotta do. But we'll see. All right, guys. Until the next one, which will be whatever, after I film plowing this storm.